Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. This time we bring you yet another Verilog project. It is a vending machine with change mechanism. I am Chaitanya Gupta and I will be walking you through this project. So the content of our video will be, I will be introducing you to the project. I will be showing you the state diagram signifying the states that our project goes through. We will discuss the Verilog code and see the results of a few simulations on it. So before we start, one important thing, 99% of you have not subscribed. Kindly subscribe and like this video and all the videos on this channel. Your support will only help us make better and longer videos for you. Share the video, share with any relative, family, anyone who you think might benefit from our videos. So yeah, kindly show some love to the channel. All right, a vending machine. Most of you must be familiar with what a vending machine is. They are unmanned mini-marts from where you can purchase any product you desire, be it snacks, beverages, stationery, etc. These machines are getting popular day by day due to their portable nature. And our project aims to simulate the way an ideal vending machine would handle transactions. Why I focus on the word ideal, I will tell you later. All right, so before I start explaining this state diagram to you, there have been some assumptions in this project. So the assumptions are the vending machine holds only one product and the product costs rupees 15. And the vending machine is in a world where the only currency denominations are rupees 5 and rupees 10. So these values are arbitrary. You might take more than one product. It would only add to the extensiveness and the complexity of your project, but the core solution will remain the same. All right. So in this state diagram, I have taken three states. Each state signifies when the vending machine has rupees 0 in it, rupees 5 in it, and rupees 10 in it. We do not require a fourth state in which the vending machine has rupees 15 because that already signifies the transaction is complete and the vending machine should revert back to state 0. And after that, this cycle can go again and again as much as the user requires. All right, so let's start. If the vending machine is in state 0, there is nothing in it. Adding nothing to it will return nothing. And the vending machine should also return no change. However, if rupees 5 was added to it, it should move to state 1 with output still 0. That is, the product should not be returned and zero change should be given. It is understandable why adding rupees 10 to the vending machine will take it to state 2. And if it is in state 1, adding 5 again would basically mean the same as this transition. And in all these cases, the transaction is still not complete, so the product is not returned. Now, let's say if the vending machine is in state 1 and nothing is added to it, the user had to go somewhere and adds nothing to it. So that is where the word ideal holds importance. An ideal vending machine should return back the change to the customer since the transaction is not complete after some time. So that transition is shown via this arrow. Adding nothing to it should return nothing but give a change of rupees 5. The same thing will happen if in state 2 nothing is added. Nothing being added this transition, the change returned is 10 and output is still 0. Now, if the vending machine is in state 1, adding 10 to it means the 15 rupees transaction is complete and output should be 1, no change is given. And if it is in state 2, adding 10, this means that there has been an overflow via the customer side. So the output is 1. The product will be returned to the customer. However, a change of rupees 5 will also be returned back. And adding 5 is again the same as adding 5 first and then 10 the second time. So I hope the state diagram is clear. There is nothing complex about it. However, you can imagine if more than one product is taken, this state diagram can be very difficult to comprehend. So for simplicity, we have taken one product. All right. So I hope the state diagram was clear to all. Let's move on to the Verilog code. I have used EDA Playground to write and run the code. You can use any tool you desire. So we make a module called vending machine. We instantiate the input and output ports we will need. I have taken a clock input to synchronize the transactional changes. A reset input is generally good to have in every machine so that we can at will reset any inside variable of that machine and make the machine as good as new. We have a 2-bit input port. Why 2-bit? Because the input can take at most 3 values, 00, 01, and 10. 00 represents that nothing was added to the vending machine. 01 represents 5 rupees was added, and 10 represents 10 rupees was added. We take an output register out. It will tell us whether the product is to be returned to the user or not. And again, a 2-bit output register for change. The same reason as input, it can take 3 values, 00, 01, 10. Okay, so we take 3 parameters for our 3 states. State 0, state 1, state 2. Please keep the state diagram handy so that it is easier for you to understand the code. We take 2-bit register for storing the current state and next state. It is necessary to store the current state and using the current state update the next state. So we need these 2 variables. All right. So at every positive edge of the clock, we start. If the reset is 1, that means the machine is to be reset. We reset all the inside variables. The current state is set to by default 0. Next state is set to 0 and change is also set to 0. Else what should happen is the current state should be equal to the next state which was acquired in the previous run through of this always block. It will be more clear when I explain the rest of the code. So after this is nothing but checking the current state and depending upon what the value is, updating the next state. So I have used a case statement for doing that. We check if the current state is S0, that means the vending machine has nothing. Adding nothing to it will change the next state to still 0. The output will still be 0 and there will be no change. Adding 5 rupees to it, the vending machine will go to state 1, output is still 0 and change is still 0. Adding 10 rupees to it will transfer the vending machine to state 2 and output and change are still 0. Now, let's say if the vending machine is in state 1, adding nothing to it, remember an ideal vending machine will return back the change. However, the output is 0 since the transaction was still not complete. Adding 5 rupees to it will transfer the vending machine to state 2. Output and change 0. Adding 10 rupees to it. Now, in this, the vending machine is in state 1. That means it holds rupees 5. Adding 10 rupees to it will make a total of rupees 15. That is, the transaction is complete. So the next state should be S0. Output should be 1. And change is still 0. Now, if the vending machine is in state 2, adding nothing to it will return a change of rupees 10. Adding 5 rupees to it will mean the transaction is complete. So the next state should go to 0. Output is 1 and the change is still 0. Now, adding 10 rupees when the vending machine already has 10 rupees means the customer overpaid. So the product is to be returned. Yes, but a change of rupees 5 has also to be returned. And we make the end statements for all our if and case conditions. and we end the module. Let's move on to the test bench. So the test bench is actually really simple. We initialize the input and output ports needed. We instantiate our module and we begin setting our values. So initially the reset is 1 to flush any garbage values. Clock starts from value 0. At the 6th time unit, reset is turned off and the input is turned on. After 5 time units, input is still 1. And after again 5 time units, input is again 1. So which case does this signify? This signifies the case where 5 rupees is added consecutively to the vending machine. So let's see how our code will perform. Let me zoom in. Okay. So the reset was turned off at the 6th time unit. Point of observation starts from here. So the input is 1 at all times as shown here. And the current state and next state are initially 0. Now at this point of observation, at this positive edge, what happens is that according to the code, we check what the current state is and accordingly update the next state. So the current state is 0, input was 1, so the next state was changed to 1. At the second positive edge of the clock, the current state was copied from the next state and the next state was changed to state 2, since the input again was 1. This happens again here. However, at this point of time, the transaction is complete since 5 rupees has been added 3 times, making a total of rupees 15. So the next state is 0. The current state is state 2. The change returned is 0 at all times. However, the input turns on. If it is not visible, let me change the cursor. All right. So here you can see here. The output turns on, meaning that the transaction is complete and the product has to be returned. And this cycle goes on the same way. So this was the case we discussed just now, adding rupees 5 3 times. To make the process faster, I have run all the simulations and put together a representation showing all the screenshots. Let's move on to the second simulation result, adding rupees 5 first and then 10 second. Our point of observation starts from here. Initially, the input is 1 for the rupees 5. So what happens is that the next state changes from state 0 to state 1. And the output and change are 0. At the second positive edge of the clock, what happens is that adding rupees 10 means a total of rupees 15 is present in the vending machine. That means it is enough for the product. So the next state should change from state 1 to state 0. And output return should be 1, meaning that the product has to be given back. The change is 0 at all times. What happens if we add rupees 10 2 times? Point of observation. Input is 2. Next state changes from state 0 to state 2. At the second positive edge, what happens is adding 10 again means that the next state has to change from state 2 to state 0. Why? Because the vending machine now holds rupees 20. So it is enough for one product. However, a change of rupees 5 has to be returned. So the output turns one and the change is also one, signifying that 5 rupees is to be returned to the customer as change. What happens if we add rupees 10 and then add nothing? So as usual, the next state will change from state 0 to state 2. At the second positive edge of the clock, what will happen is that since nothing was added, the input was changed 0 before. So what would happen is that the next state would revert from state 2 to state 0, giving back a change of rupees 2. The vending machine should not withhold the cash, any extra cash from the customer. So it has to return back any extra change. And the output is 0 since the transaction was not complete. All right, friends. So this is the end of this video. If you liked the video, please like, subscribe, and share. And if there are any doubts, please post them in the comment section down below. Thank you. We'll be right back.